Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to paint a portrait onto a brick wall from a photo. I downloaded this brick wall texture from graphicstock.com, which allows you to download unlimited images, icons, backgrounds, and much more for 7 days. I included a link in the description that'll give you a huge discount on a yearly membership. You should check it out. We want our portrait to wrap around the contours of the brick wall, so we'll make the brick wall into a displacement map. The first step is to duplicate the brick wall as a separate document by clicking the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel and clicking Duplicate Layer. Click New and type in Displacement. Then click OK. Since displacement maps work best when they're slightly blurred, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. I'll blur 3 pixels and click OK. Remove all its color by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-U. It's important that your image should have enough contrast since displacement maps are based on its tonal values. To adjust its contrast, open your Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command-L. Drag the input white slider near where the histogram starts, and do the same with the input black slider. Then click OK. We'll save it by going to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop as a Photoshop PSD file and click Save. Let's close the displacement document since we already saved it to our desktop. Open a photo of someone you'd like to make into a portrait. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. We need to make a selection around the person in order to cut it out from the background. There are many ways to make selections, and the method should depend on the characteristics of your photo. In this case, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. Its size should depend on the resolution of your photo and the size of your subject. If you're using this tool as well, drag your cursor over the subject to select it. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To make sure you've selected all of it, press Q to see the selection as a quick mask. Then press Q again to revert it back into a selection. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy your subject to its own layer. To place your subject onto the brick wall, press V to open your Move tool and drag your subject onto the tab of the wall. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the wall and release. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. To see the transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in. Then, press Enter or Return. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Before we add effects to your subject, let's protect it by converting it into a smart object. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Smart objects also allow us to modify or even change the effects at any point. Double-click on an empty area of the layer to open its Layer Style window. Click Stroke. Change the size to 2 pixels and the position is outside. Then click OK. If you notice black spots anywhere around your subject, I'll show you how to get rid of them in a minute. First, go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Fresco. I'll make the brush size 1, the brush detail 10, and the texture 1. However, feel free to experiment with these settings. Alternately, you can also try Poster Edges, which is another effective filter to use for the portrait. To get rid of any unwanted spots, click the Layer Mask icon, which makes a layer mask next to the active layer. Open your Eraser tool. To make the eraser larger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Then, brush over the spots. Convert the layer into a smart object again, and change the blend mode to overlay. Reduce its opacity to 80%. You can choose to leave the perspective of your image as it is, or angle it. If you want to angle it, we need to resize and reposition the portrait to make it ultimately fit correctly onto the angled brick wall. To do this, open your Transform tool, go to the top right corner of the transform, and press and hold Shift as you drag it in approximately this much. Then, go inside the transform, and press and hold Shift again as you slide the portrait to the left. Then, press Enter or Return. We're ready to displace the portrait so it'll wrap around the contours of the brick wall. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Make the horizontal and vertical scales 5, stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. Then click OK. Click Desktop, the Displacement PSD file, and Open. Your portrait has now conformed to the contours of your brick wall. We're going to make the portrait pop more by pressing Ctrl or Command J to copy the portrait layer and changing the blend mode to soft light. Next, we'll angle our entire image. Make a composite snapshot by pressing Ctrl Shift Alt E on Windows or Command Shift Option E on a Mac. Zoom out of your document by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard twice. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to the bottom left corner and drag it down. If you want your image to angle the other way, undo the last step and drag down the right corner. Then press Enter or Return. Fit it back onto your canvas. To give the image more depth, we'll make the wall darker as it recedes in the distance. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Gradient tool and make sure the Linear Gradient icon is active. Click the Gradient bar to open the Gradient Editor. Click the Black-White preset. Click the lower left stop and the color box. In the hexadecimal field, type in 80 three times to pick up 50% gray. Then click OK on both windows. Go to the side of your document where the wall recedes and press and hold Shift as you drag a line to the middle. Then release your cursor. Change the blend mode to linear burn and reduce its opacity to 40%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.